and gentlemen.
You guys say you're better than him?
Well, I can't get a big area though, can you?
Move your focus.
You mean back?
Push that button back.
I got a lot clearer now. But I can't get the whole room in one shot, can I?
Like I said, move your focus, you will be able to.
Okay, if I move about halfway and leave it? Can you see the color of the carpet? None of that stuff, right? You can't see the color of the carpet, though.
Not in there.
Can't see the color of your stuff?
You will on the TV.
Oh, will you?
Look at that. Try that once.
Huh?
Could you do that?
I don't know.
Look at it. It's back and then it's
down. Oh, what the thickness behind yourself.
Do you want to draw it?
No pain.
Can I look off? And I'm still moving around anyway. See, I'm still taking pictures.
And it's recording your voice. It's recording your voice.
Well, I'm not even looking in the camera. Okay, Jaybird, we'll punch it off.
Push the red button. It's right next to those two buttons you're already touching. To the, that way. Dad, back towards you, the red button.
Sing it, Elvis.
with you.
Christmas. You can now follow me to the wood pile.
Here it is. Here he is. He's bagged it down. Get it clean. You didn't.
Why did you think that?
Well, I just think that I'm sure they said something. He doesn't think they did.
They did.
Did anyone have jeans on?
Yes, three people or four.
One shirt here that isn't mine.
Ron's? Ron has never had a white sweatshirt.
I bought that shirt for Ron 3 years. Walker, and the way the deal was found, look what he's up. Did you get him in the first time?
Landy? Well, he is a very personable person. I used to play under him when he was coached with the Giants, but he doesn't give you a whole lot of extra words. There he is, now in his 27th year. He said he's going to coach his game as long as he's happy with it. I asked him today. About it. He said, I'm so happy with it.
Where'd he go?
I don't know what happened.
Inside a little
bit. Very
to do what?
Move the van.
Why?
Sitting the wrong way.
First, devastating the last 2 weeks.
I got that from your ma, you know.
You're recording. Can't you learn?
How come it blinks?
It's recording. You better talk to me now.
What should I say to you?
Mom, why don't you learn that? It's a little green light in that too.
Well, not here now with the pillows and everything, you know. See, he's got it blinking all the time. I suppose he's going to be a photographer, huh?
I suppose.
How old are you? anything planned, but it's fun to get something on there, like you said, that will be on for years. I mean,
I just want to put something away because there's so much I forget. You know, mm-hmm. I don't remember things.
You remember your birthday then?
Yeah, you should take pictures of Grandma now when she's talking
to your mouth. I got that from Ruthie.
Okay, well, I was just going to say, were there just four of you kids?
Four of us kids?
Yeah, or did you have another sister?
One died.
One died, what was that?
That between Gladys and Cornelius.
What was that, a boy or a girl?
Boy.
A boy?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. How about, like, your mom, how many, what did she have? Martin and, who was the youngest of them?
Henry. Olga. Henry was the youngest, then Olga.
And then Olga, and then?
Emil
Wiegand, and then?
Martin. And Anna.
And Grandma.
Levi,
yeah. Well, how about, what was their parents' name again? Who would, let's see, now that could be your...
Well...
That'd be your mother's folks. What was their name?
Severina Jakobsen. Well, you know, Gladys has all this written down.
I know it, but it doesn't make any difference. We can just record anything we want, you know. We can record that better from Gladys if we get more information.
Well, I mean, it'd be nice to get a kind of sensible, I mean.
How about, your dad, he was from how many kids? He's how many of them in that family?
14, 15? I'd have to count them up. I think Gladys has the picture with all of them, you know.
That's a big family.
That's a big family.
Was 11, wasn't it, or 12?
Well, two were dead, you know. I think it was 13 in all.
Goodness, what would we do with 13 now?
Yeah, what would you do?
I mean, how did they feed them all?
Well,
what did they do?
They had...
Your grandpa then, I'd be your grandpa, right?
Mm-hmm.
What did he do, a farmer?
He was a farmer.
And he supported all them kids.
And Martin farmed that where Omi has, you know.
Yeah.
That was
okay, where was your dad's home place? Your dad's home place is...
Here where Gerd only bought that old house.
North of Huff's. Where just the
house.
Oh,
the old Buchanan farm.
Buchanan farm. Mm-hmm.
Where Noose's farm now.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. That was the old Christensen...
Yeah, that's my dad's home place.
Your dad's home place. See, you know, I just learned that this last year. I didn't know that.
Well, that's where they lived, I mean.
I'm trying to think of who.
And that's where they used to go. Wasn't a double wedding there with Anna and...
Yeah.
Anton.
I guess so.
Got married. Anna married Landmark. And Anton married Gina. And that was the same night. And Dad went over there and stayed till pretty in the morning because, you know, they danced or played cards or...
Did any of them play musical instruments?
Martin played a piano.
Martin.
Did he?
The fiddle.
Oh, I remember when Martin came and played my piano.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's right. Did he play the fiddle too?
He played the fiddle.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know about the others.
Well, Henry was a musician, kind of musical.
Oh, was he?
Mm-hmm.
I remember that now. He used to come and chord.
Yeah.
He used to chord.
He used to sit and chord on your...
Yeah, he chorded on the piano.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
And which one was it that was down in the toilet in the home place and the other one stood up in the yard and shot right through the toilet?
I don't know.
Levi and Henry, wasn't it?
I suppose.
Is that on the place, your place now?
Oh.
On your farm?
Really?
And they used to have dance in the granary there, you know.
Oh.
See, Martin.
Which granary?
In the granary.
Our old granary.
Old granary where we had grain.
Why would you have a dance in that little thing?
Well, we had a dance there.
During the tough times, the 30s.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but there was no room in there.
Well, it wasn't that middle wall. It still is written on a wall, no smoking.
Really? I've got to look for that. Oh, but then, okay, then the Wiegand home place, that's your grandma and grandpa built that then?
No. Yeah, they just had a sod house to start with. And then
where was that?
Right where Just
a little bit north of the house.
Yeah, a little bit north of the house.
You kind
of
walk across it when you go from the house to the barn.
That's where they live.
And the sod house.
I mean, the moth folks then, you know.
Okay, and that's what, Johannes?
Johannes Jakobsen something. But I haven't got the right
name. He changed his name to Wiegand then.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
What was her name?
Severina.
Okay. And he built that house.
Well, they just built it of sod, you know.
Yeah, but not the house not, that you have on the farm now,
yeah.
He built.
Yeah.
But then didn't they raise the...
Yeah, they raised it so it got higher.
So you got two stories? Was it only one story?
No, it was
one. No, it was kind of two stories, but they raised it about 2 feet.
To get higher, you know, to get the bedrooms.
It goes up in the attic.
Oh.
And he built the altar for a marble church.
The altar?
Yeah.
Where
is Preka store? The one they preach out of.
The altar too, isn't it?
Yeah, the one they preach out of too, you know.
Did he build a baptismal font too?
Yeah.
Seems to me I remember hearing that.
Yeah.
At Marble, you're saying.
Yeah.
Are they still using that?
Oh, I don't know.
It worked miracles, Patty.
Can it?
Yep,
yeah.
It worked.
Yeah. Was that your suggestion?
Yeah.
Should I give you another
hint? Yeah, give me another hint.
I'll put it back in the bedroom. Laurie said put it back in the bedroom. But I'll cooperate because then maybe you'll move along quicker. See, your dad's put out a lot of cabbage trees.
Yeah, isn't he though?
Yeah, but he likes that. And he's thin, he can eat it.
Of course, it's not a good stuff.
You're not considered. No, she's
eating
out far. Or she ordered it for me.
That's a good
thought. Here I want that. Can you believe that? Good one. It says in here. That's it, I have.
Hello, ladies.
It's a nice card for them.
We missed the plane. We were in Sioux Falls waiting for him to pick them up. So we got paid.
Cheryl,
we were even there.
Way back.
Had to go back to Floyd.
Oh.
We had to go back the next day to him again.
What do you have for homework,
Charlie?
Not much. And then you say nothing now. It's either you're something.
Here we met her. On the road. Stop. How'd you get that dish out of the ground? Move it down the road. Oh, yeah.
Oh, Julian.
Well, he went up there. Turned around.
Hi, Brenda. Aren't you hungry yet?
Hey, Ron, you take Jeff on the game of baseball. He's a twin.
Me and Tommy just made strong.
Your combine, yeah. So,
did you guys make numbers?
So we were like fourth
grade.
Trying to chase all that.
Yeah.
You're
just
doing
all the
holes.
Oh, hey. Harlan's
got
it.
There
you go.
Go for
it. You see Harlan's tearing down south of his main office.
He's supposed to cut her part.
No.
Don't want to say no, but I'm going to take it.
Come on, talk to me, man. There's each of bashful people.
Yeah, be on TV.
Would you like being on TV?
I said,
how do you feel
today?
He sold out of one.
Must be different.
Hi,
Betty.
Oh, God. Love that camera when I'm on.
You and Slim got the bell, now you can tell me about that now.
Oh, I helped get it, slide it off the railroad car onto the wagon, team and wagon then, and haul it up this place street, and then we had to plank it then, or a heavy timber, slide it all the way up the steps, you know.
Did it come in a flat car or in a box car?
I'll call it a box car.
Yeah.
I had to get it straightened up to get the, all the tackles and timber way up in top, and it was strong enough to hold it.
How many, what year was this again? Remember?
About 24, I believe.
Yeah.
But I'm sure what time of the year it was.
I suppose it'll say in some of their books.
Oh, I'm sure.
Yeah.
I suppose it's in that book, maybe, the one it was put in.
Reading, you can't read.
And they couldn't write very good.
Well, some of them wrote.
They wrote fancy, but it's so hard to read. Yeah.
It was fancy.
Who helped with putting up the tower?
The bell?
Yeah, or the bell, yeah.
Oh, a lot of people helped to get it hoisted up there.
Slim was kind of the main man, though.
Yeah, there was quite a few around. There.
What year did you say? I didn't.
24.
I think it was 24. But I wasn't sure if the 24, that same winter then or what. I don't remember what the time of the year was.
I don't know.
But I know there wasn't any snow on the ground.
That's what I was going to say. You said you used a wagon, so it was really
yeah,
the middle of winter.
There wasn't any snow on the ground. No.
Yeah, you know, too, they must have, it was tin on the floor, you know, where the bell sat. Well, and they had to hold the bell up there until they built that in, I suppose.
Yeah, yeah.
And then it was tin over the whole floor, you know.
Why is that?
For leak water. No, this, it was just
open.
It's
open there,
yeah. It was just screens around, you know.
But had we taken down some part of the tower?
No. Kenny says there was a railing on
some
the top.
Some railing on top
of the very top.
There's about a 3-foot railing around the top.
That was taken down.
Yeah, that cross wasn't there.
No.
Hans put that cross up.
He took the railing down and put the cross up.
Yeah, because that was all rotted. And I think he'd done that when Colvig was here, if I'm not mistaken.
That could have been.
Yeah.
But that cross was up a long time before I ever knew it.
That's right.
You know, you just keep on.
How did Hans get that cross on top of there himself?
I don't know. I suppose he probably nailed it together up there, I'd say.
He built it up
there. But see, in where you crawl through, you had a little hole. That's where it, well, you can see it, I suppose.
You can see it now. Yeah. When it's
right. You crawled up on top of it.
It's like a little hatch.
Yeah.
You talking about Hans Hagsted now?
Yeah.
And I suppose, how old was he when he did that?
Well, Julian said it was 25 years ago since Colvig come here last year.
Yeah, I suppose about that.
Remember,
now he's what?
27 years. But I mean, we helped unload Colvig this year, and you said it was 25 years ago.
Well, Colvig come here when Ron was come here baptized.
Yeah, Ron was a baby when he came.
Yeah.
He's born in 62.
How old is Hans?
You're right.
How old
is Hans?
82. He's 20 years old.
Oh, yeah, it's my mom's age.
62, but he could have been 63.
Yeah, I don't know, but I mean, it's, this is just guessing, too, but I think it was about Colvig's time.
Yeah.
Either when he first came here, that, so that'd be 25 years, 27 years ago, I think.
When was Hans's birthday? October? We missed it.
Mm-hmm.
Who's?
Hans's birthday is February 9th.
Oh, we missed it. I knew it.
Same day as my mom's.
And I always bake him a cake.
Oh.
I'll have to do that anyway, won't I? Oh, goodness.
But I found a slip when they had given the altar and the altar railing and the chairs.
About that
the price is there what it was that time.
In the front of the church? Who gave that or who bought it?
Anna Ramlo gave it, and I think she gave it in memory of her daughter.
So you're saying 57 or 58?
Mrs. Gilbert?
Does that sound right?
Mrs. Anna Ramlo, I think that would be Gilbert's mother.
Or something like that.
Gilbert Ake? No.
Gilbert Ramlo's mother.
Gilbert Ramlo's mother.
I think it's Gilbert Ramlo's mother.
I am Carvel Johnson.
The price was on this piece of paper. Well, it was the altar,
Frank Weir,
the altar railing and the kneeling, the
Carl
pads and the
Carl
chairs
that we were trustees
from there. And
at
that
the
was
time,
about 60
I know we went down to
for all of it.
And
then
done
the
something
painting
in the same order.
In the altar.
You see that in that realm?
It was given by Miss Lucid.
But what year it is,
our memory of Odin Lucid that died in the service overseas. And she gave
down
the painting
field
and
the same
baptismal font.
Her same
painting was $100 in the baptismal font.
But they had it all in one.
Something.
Oh, yeah.
All in one.
She never sat for it.
But I said, oh, that's no good. We better see if we can split that. So that's so got a little landing then, you know. Somebody should fall, they go all the way down.
I'm not going to knock that big building down on the TV.
Yeah, look
it. Above the,
that's a
above the doorway that we got there now.
Yeah.
That was there before they took the new
app. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Because that they just took that out and moved it off. But that wasn't the Hans didn't put that up right away either, you know.
No.
That was storage someplace.
Yeah.
Hans need. Too bad they didn't figure to build it in.
Mm-hmm.
See, it's sitting inside the.
Yeah.
No, but
Kenny, turn that lamp off. I know I'm going to get just a glare. Yeah. I'm just going to get a glare on him, you know, with the light right behind him.
But I don't remember what the area put in that front, though.
Yeah. Well, it's in between 56 and 58.
Don't
you? Yeah, that's the way Ruthie said,
too. Well, wait a minute. Glenn, the new entry was up when we got married.
Yeah,
58. June of 58, it's there.
Yeah, well, 57. So
but was it finished?
Well,
was that new entry finished?
Yeah, I'd say it was.
Yeah, it was finished. It was finished all at once.
Yeah, it was pretty much, I think.
Yeah.
I was trying to think of who else.
Did she get the TV?
I helped on that a little bit.
Did you?
I remember I was there once and Reverend Erickson, he'd take those 4x6s and push them up and he could stand on the ground and see the boards, the roof.
Oh.
See, they're 4x6s, you know.
Yeah.
He'd stand and push them right up there.
When did Reverend Erickson die?
58.
Yeah, 50. I think under 50 it was
the
next year.
Huh?
It was the next year after Schaefer died.
But I mean, we moved out on the farm, what, 58? It's either that summer or the next summer.
Okay, and a new 50 in Osmondville.
Okay.
When did Schaefer come?
He married us.
Oh, you were married in
married 58.
Yeah, he came
from Lila Mass
for the
name?
First one.
Yeah. Because
Lila
I
remember
Reverend Erickson said once, why didn't you ask me? I would have married you.
Come about the first of the year?
Yeah, I can't remember.
Seems to me you did.
Made that announcement.
Well, in the other kind of anniversary play, you paid good for us between seven and the books there now, I bought each one of my kids one of those, and we bought a few extra, too, so we've even got a few extra of those, if I can find them. I looked for the other day, and I couldn't even find them.
You can't find them when you're
Bob Hoffman still living?
Carmen,
no, Bob is dead.
Is he?
Yeah, he
About everybody down here in the front.
I have to tell
There were two windows on the east on each side the altar.
Oh.
They were down lower at one time. I remember we came up there.
Oh, I could see something on the wall, you know. Kind of
you see it in church, all this seemed like it was a bird sitting on the middle of a...
It was.
A nest up there.
Then, when the pulpit was in the middle of the church, you remember how it used to be?
Yeah.
Well, the sun would shine through those windows, and they said it would bother them, they couldn't see. Yeah. So then Hanson built louvers outside those two windows.
Well,
so the sun didn't shine in the light. That's where those birds would sit, you know, walk along.
But then the windows didn't show up very good, and they put them louvers down.
No, yeah, but then didn't they cover them with some black paper once? And that didn't get taken off for a long time.
No, they had a screen outside there, I think, for a while.
Or a screen or something to keep the birds off.
Yeah, I think that's what they did for a while. I don't know.
Practically every Sunday, if you looked up there, you know, there was a bird kind of walking back and forth across the window.
They had nests up there, too, I seen, from the outside.
When did we get that organ? And what did we have before that?
Organ.
Probably that old pump organ I got in the house over there.
Well, I think it was
well, motor. There's a picture of, in 52, there's a picture of Bertha Hengstead sitting by an old organ. Right there in that book. Toward the front there. It shows the organ.
40 years since we got the organ.
How many?
40.
40, so that
would be...
That isn't 40, that's only 36. No. This here,
36? That's 52.
No, 52, I say 36 years old.
Oh. Yeah, but we got the organ before that.
Well, that's, yeah. I'm
oh, is that the same organ?
That isn't possibly the organ in the basement that we had down there for fitting the framing and stuff.
Well, I think I read it in the minutes or something. But for the new Hammond organ, I thought that was 48.
Well, what did that cost?
That'd be 40 years ago.
Yeah.
Remember what it cost?
No, I don't know if it said what it cost.
Julian, you know what I think? You know, the furnace is older than 68 or 69. I'd say the furnace was in 2-3 years before that.
Yeah, I think so too.
The damper by manual.
I think so too. It was,
yeah.
In the, it was down in the basement.
Yeah, it's in the back furnace.
This furnace?
Yeah. It was. Yeah, but it was in 69 that August Hammer made a motion, I think it was 69, to build a furnace, new and buy a new furnace.
Oh, build, okay, then it's that.
And then it was after that, but I couldn't find when they had decided to buy a furnace.
So it's 20 years old then.
Did they sue the furnace company?
It wouldn't be 19.
That's not really so old.
No, 15, 16, 17. We sue the furnace company for $1 million.
Seems to me it's older.
Me too, but it probably isn't.
Well, that's what I was going to say too.
But they moved the old furnace then down in the basement one time, the old coal furnace.
Yeah,
that's just about in that hallway where you go back to the kitchen.
And you took the coal bin out there and put the restrooms back there, right?
Yeah.
No, the coal bin was behind the restroom, wasn't it?
Well, yeah. They probably took up that one restroom.
Yeah, but wasn't there that one room, the men's room back there, wasn't that behind?
Well, that was kind of in the coal room. I don't know how big the coal room was.
The coal room was, I think, where the wall is now. You know, that where that storage
was. Was that as big as the coal room was, you think?
Yeah, I think
that's where the library is.
Yeah.
Oh, there.
I thought
that's
maybe
where
was,
the stoker
was. I thought maybe it was bigger than that.
No, not much.
I know it was a dirty old place at one time.
Well, up underneath there, it still was dirty, you know, like the, where the lights and things were. Every time you get up and change a light bulb or up in there, you know how it's still up.
Yeah.
There was that soot and that dirt.
Oh, yeah,
and,
it was,
oh, in
yeah, it
there
was pretty soot in that room.
Oh, yeah.
Before they covered it the family.
Yeah.
Oh,
stuff.
You can't get rid of that stuff.
What year was it that we did
the
basement?
Yeah, this is the new organ at Bertha's anyway.
Is it? Oh, yeah.
Like
it looks
zero.
Like it's got
yeah.
these wooden
yeah.
deals on the floor.
40 years then.
I don't think the old one had that.
Yeah.
No.
Well, was it an old pump organ?
Well, it had a motor on it.
It had a motor, yeah. It had been converted.
It
was a pump
panel. But then they put a motor on it for that blower.
Yeah, the switch on it. You had to turn that on to get.
I know down home I had that, you know. One had to sit and pump that thing all the time. When But when did he get the new organ then?
40 years.
40 years.
40 years.
40 years. Yeah.
40 years. They bought a new Hammond organ. 48. I'm sure it was 48.
How much? $3,000 at that time.
Oh, no, I can pay for that organ.
For that new organ, I remember.
How much is in the organ fund now? Is there that much?
Nancy Sandry told me she bought an organ, electronic, for just a house, $7,000 now. That just, she says that's a small one. She says it cost you $10,000 to $15,000 to get just any kind of a, organ for children. Yeah, I mean, and that would be on the cheap end, I suppose.
I hear $1,000 that altar. We're given the altar and the altar ring and the two chancel chairs were given by Mrs. Anna Ramlo Erickson in memory of her departed daughter, Marie. The altar painting and the baptismal font given by Mrs. John Brusett in memory of her son, Odie. Hymn board by Chris Timfer. The hymn boards cost $25.
Were they the green ones?
The board. Oh, the old.
How much did they cost?
$25.
Of course, they were kind of fancy.
But
at that time, I suppose that's quite a bit.
Seemed like a lot of money back in 1920.
I see. Part of
your altar cost, you suppose?
About $400. Well, that's $400 down.
Is that all cost, really?
Yeah, it was $66 for the two chairs. It was $468, I think, for the altar, the altar ring, and the two chairs.
Yeah, for the new altar one.
And this was just on a piece of tablet paper. It happened to fall out of that book.
$100
And this altar painting, and that was $100 for the painting.
You mean the picture of Christ? I thought that was foolish. Walking on the water, or what was it?
Descending.
Yeah.
Ascending on the way. It's the same thing that Marvel's got.
Exact same picture.
That new directory. It's smaller, I think.
That's why we used that on the cover. Because both churches had the same picture.
That cost $100
and something? No. The painting was $100 and it was $28.80 for the baptism.
Well, the altar was the cheapest thing.
And I told this to Norris last night. And your baptismal font like that, if you saw it in a museum or antique store, $700-$800. With that kind of hard oak wood and that fancy carving.
I see part of the Sunday school record board is still hanging there.
Oh, is that the Sunday school record board? I saw it as part of one of those boards hanging
there. I thought it was the top one, you know, and I started to look while it was down this low, and the other one was up there.
I know, I've seen it someplace.
It's still hanging on.
And that little table that's put beside the chair by the altar, no?
Yeah. I listen.
That's still there.
I just
tried
to read about this.
I don't know
stuff.
If it's all there, but
it wasn't by the altar anymore.
Well, I suppose he had moved it, see, when he was cleaning there, probably.
No, see, it was a PA system that was on there.
Over in that. Was that what's standing
right next
table?
To that pew, in that. About this square?
Yeah.
Kalvig used to have, they used to sit next to a chair. Yeah, they
used to
book
that. Right next to the back entry. Over there, I don't know if all the parts are there, but. That isn't even burnt.
I can't.
You know, well, that kind of scorched a little, but it is. And the rug, you can see exactly where all these things go, the organ and fiber plants and all that. And now it's smoked up, see? So the rug is all covered with smoke, but you can see exactly where each thing is. And it just tips down. All
plug and I'll just use the inside of it. Piano top is still there.
I'll leave it put here now and I'll eat.
Oh, yeah.
Trying to roll in on that.
Are they melted or what?
No. Maybe one or two, but no. That drafts are on it.
I don't know what for you.
Pretty hard stuff. But the can lover, they were all busted up.
You need it. Well, they were just about busted before.
Yeah, but I had them fixed.
They were wired.
I know, but then,
they had wire on them, where they were wired up.
Yeah, one time they were an awful shape.
Yeah, but
somebody took them and got them fixed.
Ruthie fixed them.
No.
No.
Yeah,
Dwayne Boosett, I think, fixed them.
Yeah, but didn't you fix them once?
Well, I tried working on it, but no, I didn't get them fixed.
I thought you were the one that fixed them. I remember some.
I probably was the one that hollered.
Oh, don't make any difference. But they were, you know, you'd stick a candle in, you know, and you'd tip that whole thing off, it'd come off.
Yeah, it was bad.
Some of
that's where you guys farm. Yeah. Frank built part of the pulpit. I wonder if they didn't find some of that off the tree.
Oh, really? I'm going to get out there and look now.
They'll start opening it, my friend.
Remember where they put it out in the
trees?
No,
I wouldn't know where they put
what's
it.
What's out in the trees now?
Part of the old East Church.
In Sam?
Sam Swenson.
Jasper Swenson's farm.
Oh, in that place.
Might find something else
out there. You know, I've kind of looked the place over pretty good, you know?
Glenn found something.
Wasn't much, so.
Edwin Olsen bought the handsome old church, didn't he?
Yeah.
Well, Faith bought it first.
Huh?
Faith Lutheran bought it first. They bought it at the sale.
What?
Faith.
The guys up in Faith Lutheran bought it.
Bought Hansonville?
Yep. Because I was there when they bought it. Remember that.
Oh, I know you need everyone.
Cost too much to move it, or?
Cost too much to move it. They sold it to Edwin Olsen somehow. I don't know how they did it. We bought the collection plate out.
You mean to tell me it's 7 years ago since Faith started? Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah, it's been a while.
Well, when did we merge?
Schaefer, when did he leave? That's when.
63, and when Colby came.
Okay, then it's 25 years. Okay, I'll get some back off.
But then we were downtown for a while, you know, before they built.
Yeah, I know.
But I mean, 25 years ago, that handsome old church was still there. Mm-hmm. So.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
That's
48, the organ. We haven't got. That's only 52, isn't it? The entry was built what, 57, 8. We haven't got that pinpointed. Norris, you got the 100th book there.
56-7 in that range. Right.
Oh, 5-6-7.
Oh no, you don't have to. I saw. They were all red and.
Red and blue.
Yeah.
What lights where?
Right here.
Do they
see
show?
A couple of bulbs there, you know, right over there. Maybe that's a better picture.
Yeah, no, just hold it for me. Where are you saying the lights were now?
The right, it went across the whole.
Across that archway?
Yep. It was red and blue.
I thought it was red and green.
Well, it was blue.
The lights on red arch, you know.
But I can't ever remember seeing them there.
Was it red and blue?
Yeah, once in a while, wasn't it Christmas?
Christmas time, probably. I never remember. They even had them over these
little
small
ones
too.
Yeah.
Reminds you of a ballroom, a dance.
I don't remember. I'd forgotten it. When they say it now, I know it was there.
I know it.
You can remember it too. Huh?
I think I remember it, but I don't.
Can't remember what it was.
But I never remembered it until you say it.
They were there
in
52 then.
How old are you today, Mom? How old are you today then?
I am 79 years old.
79 years old today.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's good then. How are you feeling today then?
Better
today?
Yeah.
That's good. Were you born in the morning, afternoon, night?
What?
When were you born in the morning, afternoon, night?
Oh, I think I was born at night.
I don't remember that.
Like, you know. Text them, she said, she's over, I look at the clock, she said.
She's older than you are, huh?
She's the time she's older than I am because she looked at the clock, wow. She said.
Well, she didn't know you at that time.
So she get a straight answer from her sometimes.
Do you ever have a dream like that?